And as promised, we have Vince Redmond joining us. We want to dive right in because we're low on time here.
Yeah, so Vince, we asked if we could talk with you today about, it's hard for parents when they have a child on the spectrum, especially when they're doing ABA, they don't know when they're, what, you know, because the therapist will want to push our kids. And we don't, sometimes they'll cry. We don't know when is too much. Like a child gets tired, when is it too much? And when is it our anxiety and us holding them back?
Yeah.
So what advice can you give to parents who are feeling like, I don't want to push my child?
I think that's a longer conversation than just in the moment, right? I think a lot of this proceeds with the orientation and talking to them about ABA and how repetition and exposure to treatment and higher levels of treatment is what is the success of ABA and how children relearn or that's the way they learn new concepts, new ideas, new skills. So I think this conversation has to start very early on, even before we might see that the child is working harder, you know, at times might be working too hard, so that we can minimize some of the misunderstanding on parents' end on, oh, they're bored, or they've done this too many times, or I don't want them to have to do that again and again and again, because that's the basis of ABA, is that repetition and exposure to stimuli and the treatment. So I think some early education is absolutely necessary. And then as we get going into the treatment, I think good communication about typical daily events are essential, right? Is the child ill? Did the child not sleep last night? Have they not eaten? You know, those types of things need to be communicated and put into consideration, not only by the family, of course, but by the clinicians as well. The clinicians need to be aware of some of these naturally occurring things so that they can adapt their treatment plan for the day, or maybe look at doing things in a different order so that the child's motivation will increase, so their attention will increase, and they'll have a better session. So I think all along, we start with early education and communication with families, not only about ABA, but how intensive the services are. We want to minimize any distractions or maybe overloading them with other activities that they're going to do, because I think sometimes it's a belief that having another activity might increase their motivation, where sometimes it actually just increases the amount of frustration they have. And then I think the day-to-day communication on, you know, how they're feeling, what's going on, is essential to make any, you know, last minute adaptations that might be necessary.
I think it's really hard for a parent, because our gut, whenever our kid starts crying or we see that they're tired, we go, we should stop now.
Right.
And often the clinicians will be like, no, you know, we're going to be mindful and we're going to keep going on.
Right.
It's okay for your child to get frustrated. It's okay for your child to be tired. But we want to keep making that progress. And it's very hard because we tell parents all the time, we go with your gut, go with your gut, right? But there are times when our gut will try to protect our child from progress. I'm guilty as charged. I had said to you in an email yesterday, Vince, that, you know, I would like to just duct tape my son to the wall every day so that he'll be safe and leave him there.
Mm-hmm.
But every day I have to let the leash out a little bit and have him do something that I'm not entirely comfortable with. And it has gotten easier the better he has done. But there were years in the beginning where my son didn't talk and I was like, I don't want to do this. But what do we, like, I know I had people talking to me the whole time saying, if you do that, it's you holding him back. That worked for me. I don't know that works for other parents. What's your opinion on that, Vince?
Well, and I think it's that communication, right? It's talking to you about not only the science behind ABA, but what are you experiencing? Let's talk through what you're experiencing as well, right? No parent likes to see their child struggle. We don't like to see them cry. We don't like to see them whine. We don't like to see them suffer. We don't like to see them get things wrong and fail, right? So talking through it with your clinician is absolutely important so that we can work through our anxieties and sometimes understandings of things so that the clinician can also understand where we're coming from. Right? Because as a parent, that's something that we don't like to hear. However, the failing and the missing and the getting things wrong is how they're learning. That is the most powerful learning tool that they have, is getting something wrong and not being able to get the their desired response, and then doing something right to get their desired response, and then continuing to do that over and over again. So part of the learning is the failing, is the crying, is the frustration that comes with it. Now, of course, there's limits to it, and we don't want to, get the child so upset that they're no longer learning. But part of the learning does involve some failing and some crying and some whining and some unhappy times, because that's where they're actually learning, because they're not getting their desired result by the behavior or by the action that they're doing. And we're teaching them to get it, they do something different. So I think sometimes along with that early education is that empathetic understanding that it's tough for everyone to see the kids cry. It's tough for us as the clinicians to see the kids cry. And, as a team, we get through it by good communication with each other, by good understanding of one another, and then also understanding what the goals are.
Yeah. Vince, I know we have to let you go. We can't thank you enough, and I'm sorry
you.
We didn't leave enough time to go into this further with you, but thank you so much for being with us.
No problem. Have a great rest of the week.
Okay, you too, Vince.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thanks for watching Autism Live. To subscribe, click here. And if you'd like to check out some more of our videos, click here.